pases, te prometo no faltarte. No me siento grande por ti, y aunque lo intentara no podría sin ti. Toda mi felicidad es gracias a ti, y si yo me muero volvería por ti.
Hey guys, so for this video you're gonna learn how to inject your own Lovenox shot. So basically the Lovenox, or also known as inoxaprin sodium injection, is a blood thinner. And what that means is that instead of your blood clotting, it'll now be like water. Don't get into an accident when you take these injections, because that'll turn into a pretty ugly situation. But that's what the injections look like. And how it works is gonna be shown in a different clip, because I can't do injections sitting down. All right guys, so I wanted to give you guys more of an HD look, because when I showed you guys before, it wasn't really that clear. So I wanted to get more of a clear shot for you guys. So these are what the injections look like. Apparently this is where mine come from, like the company or whatever. And mine come with 10 syringes in each pack. That's the dosage that they gave me, 40 milligrams. And that's what the box looks like. And if you turn the box over, it has some directions, but I'm gonna show you guys some tips and tricks on how to inject yourself. That's so weird to say. But when you take the top off of the box, because the box will come sealed, I already took the top off of it, this is what you're gonna see. And it's a pack of 10, so that's like the rows of them. And I'm gonna explain to you exactly what these pieces are of it. So when you take it out, that's what it looks like. And the pieces are this piece right here is the actual needle, but it's being covered by a protective cap, so you don't obviously accidentally inject yourself before you want to. And then this right here is where your actual fluid of the injection is. And this is your little release thing that you push down on when you're giving yourself the injection. And yeah, that's what it looks like. That's what the dosages and what it says, whatever. When you turn them over, this is what they look like. It gives you the lot number of the injections and the expiration date. And obviously this is where you peel it off. It's actually really easy to peel it off, but yeah, if you didn't know, that's where you peel it to open it up, of course.
Okay, so I know you can't see my face. I'm sorry, that's the angle that I had to put you guys at, so you guys can clearly see how this is gonna work and how you inject yourself. Now, they usually tell you with these injections that you do it 2 inches away from the belly button. So it'd kind of be like that, spaced out from your belly button. But I don't do that, just because being 9 months pregnant, and I am really out of breath, I'm so sorry. This is like pregnancy stuff. I never thought that I would experience this, but dude, when you get to your last month, I swear to God, you can't breathe. But anyways, so that's like two inches, so that would be 1, 2. That's still clearly really where the baby is. So I don't really feel comfortable doing that. So what I do personally, you can take your doctor's advice and do it there, but I don't feel comfortable doing that, because I feel like I'm gonna like poke a hole into her amniotic bag and all the fluids are gonna pop out, and you know, she's gonna have to be delivered early or whatever. So what I do is I usually give my injection around the upper hip area. So here's where my hip is. I do it on the upper hip area, like the side stomach. And either way, whatever you do it, like whether you do it here or over here, the rule is pinch an inch. That's literally the rule that they teach you. that's the same, pinch an inch. So it's really true, when you wanna inject yourself, you wanna grab it like an inch of skin and then inject yourself. But before you do that, you're gonna disinfect the area that you're going to inject. So you can either do alcohol, they recommend alcohol, but lately because of the coronavirus, everyone's been buying out all the alcohol. So there's no way I can find alcohol. So we're using the next best thing. And we're gonna go with hydrogen peroxide, which also kills bacteria. And I just put it on a little tiny piece of paper. Just wipe where you're gonna be injecting, so it kills the bacteria. You go ahead and grab the injections that I just showed you. And since it comes in two, you're gonna break it in half. It's fine, they come apart together. They're still sealed. That's how they're designed to work. You put the, wow, that really just fell to the floor. It would look like this, and you take the top where it says peel here on the white side, and you literally peel it, obviously. And this is your actual injection. So now what you do is you take the protective cap that I mentioned before on the top, you take that off, and you keep that cap. Keep that cap. I literally threw it over there, but I know where it is. Keep that cap. Now you find a place that you want to inject that doesn't have a vein, or where you don't see a vein. And the reason for that being is because if you do hit a vein, number one, it's going to be painful. Number two, it'll probably bleed a shit ton. And number three, it'll bruise like a motherfucker, dude. So you wanna find a place that does not have a vein, and it's gonna be trial and error a lot of the time, and you'll really figure out where you're most comfortable injecting yourself. Also, side note, sometimes you are going to inject a place and it will hurt. If it hurts like you feel like you're about to go through a vein, or like you've poked a vein, personally, what I have done is I did not continue when that happened, so I didn't keep going. Yeah, that's practically what other videos don't tell you, is that if you feel like you're going through a vein, don't keep going. Switch to a different place, okay? Don't put yourself through that. I will mention right now that the injection does burn. I don't know why. It's just some quality inside of this injection that makes it burn. And I will admit that through around like month six or five-ish, sometimes it'll burn and sometimes it won't. I guess that's how your body like accustoms, and it will just stay like that. Like sometimes, even now at 9 months, it burns sometimes, but sometimes, most of the time it doesn't, because my body has become accustomed. But in the beginning, it's gonna burn like you're in hell. So yeah, that's that.
Once you have it in there, I really don't know how to clearly show that, but once you have it in there, here's my other tip. If you're starting out, me personally starting out, I did it really, really, really slowly. Like I would take 5 minutes injecting this, because the slower I went, the less it burned for me. But now I'm kind of to the point where like I'm over it, so I just do it all at once. So, I mean, really your preference on which way you want to do it. Both ways give you the same result. It's not like one way is gonna make you bruise more than the other, but yeah. And then I press down a little bit to make sure I get the last, like if you can see what I'm doing, you probably can't, but I press down on the injection thing to make sure I get all of it. Then I slowly remove it, and now I'm gonna put this down. And now You don't want to keep that needle out because it will poke someone. What they tell you in the doctor's office is you can throw the cap away and just do this. You push on this very firmly. This only happens when you push on it very firmly. It's not gonna happen when the needle is inside of you if you don't push extremely hard, which you shouldn't when you're injecting yourself, but FYI. So this is what should happen. And that pops out. That's the protection cap, so no one injects themselves. The little springy thing ejects, because that springy thing is not here on the other one that hasn't been ejected. That springy thing gives that cap out. This one still has the needle out. This one has the cap out. And it won't bounce back because of the springs, so it can't poke anybody. But I don't necessarily trust that. So what I personally recommend doing is keeping the cap, like I said before, putting the cap back onto that needle, and then ejecting the spring. That way you have a double protection to make sure no one really gets poked. Yeah, that's practically it on my tips and tricks for this injection. You do inject the whole needle. I didn't mention that in the meeting, but you do inject the whole entire needle. It's not really that big if I were to guess. It's probably just like 3/4 of an inch. And also, if you ever do bleed, which I have, don't freak out. Just go and grab probably like a little tiny piece of regular paper like this that I use to clean the skin, and apply pressure to it for about 5 minutes, and it should probably stop. If in any case the bleeding does continue, I would recommend that you seek medical attention, because these are blood thinners, of course. So if there is no like outlooks that it's going to stop bleeding, obviously you want to get medically seen for that before you bleed out and die.
But I will see you guys in the next video.